Hey everyone. Have you ever had trouble in HubSpot when you have a deal or a company that has multiple contacts or multiple line items or multiple things, multiple records associated with them, and you want to then use that information in Zapier and then send an email or connect it up with Xero or do something else with the data? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can build this in Zapier to solve this problem so that you can get all these details here into an email so you don't have an issue where you have to send an email individually to each of these different people or do something manually as well. So in Zapier and with HubSpot, one of the challenges is that when you're creating a relationship and you're using the get company or get contact action step or task step, you can only get one detail at a time. If your deal, for example, if the deal has multiple companies or contacts or other records associated with it, it's going to have an error. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to get around that error, how to build this app in another way so that you can get the information you need for the later steps. Like for example, sending an email. So what I'm going to show you here, let me start by explaining. In this example, we're talking about a deal stage in HubSpot moving to the closed stage, closed one stage. But you could build this in other ways with a trigger step that's for contacts or for companies, deals, products, whatever, any other thing you're doing in HubSpot, or even with other similar kinds of platforms like HubSpot, which use these associations and objects sort of step. And so what we're going to go through is basically when this deal changes to closed one, then it's going to send an email to these five people all together in one email. That's what we're going to do today. So let's go through the Zap. Basically, this is what I've already built, and feel free to share any questions, any concerns, any ideas for making this faster, smarter, or anything. I'm sure I would really like to try this with ChatGPT as well, but in this video, there's no ChatGPT, there's no AI. It's just the flow, the manual flow, the normal flow inside Zapier. So let's go through it. So we start with the deal stage in HubSpot. And what we're doing, let me jump into the edit draft. And then we've got, so let's go through it. So let's zoom in a bit. So we start with update deal stage in HubSpot. And so we're saying the deals pipeline, any deal that gets closed one gets enrolled in this Zap. We pull in the details like this, continue with the record. Then we're going to find the associations with this deal, because right now in HubSpot, we only have the details of the deal, this side, let's say. We don't know the relationships to any contacts or companies or any other different objects. We've only got the deal data like this. So we've got to find the associations with the other objects. And I've done a separate video about associations with objects in HubSpot and with Zapier. So check that out. I'll link that up at the top there. And now we're going to select the ID we're using is the ID from the closed one step, the trigger, and it's a deal. The object's called a deal. We're going to get two areas, two different objects, the company and the contact, company's object and the contact's object. We could also use this step to get line items and other things as well. Potentially, I might do another video on that as well. Let me know in the comments if you want a video about line items, and also let me know in the comments if you want to see any videos about how I would do this with AI instead of all these steps as well. So if you're interested, I'll do those videos. So we find associations, we get the company data. So we pull that information in from here. So we've tested this out. We've gotten this deal to companies with the code for the company. We've got this deal to contacts with the code for the contacts associated. And so then we got to get this company step. The event is get this company. We add in, obviously we connect everything up with HubSpot already as well. We add in the company ID, the number like this. We go continue, test, and we get the company details. And then the important part here is we're going to create a loop step, because we're assuming the deal only has one company associated with it. And maybe the way your business works, it's different. But let's say most businesses have clients that are just one company in a deal. But you might have multiple contacts. It's quite common to maybe have two or three contacts that are related to a specific deal. So we then add a we're going to add a loop. So we're going to use this loop to kind of do a multiple search and pull the details for each time there's a contact. We could do this in another way if we knew that it was always two contacts or always three contacts. But because we don't know, sometimes the contacts might be one, two, three, four, five, who knows? We need to create a loop that's just going to keep looping until there's nothing else for it to search for. Okay, so that's the loop step. Let's open that up. So I've called this one contact. And then the detail that I'm putting in here is this. There are three, in this example, there's three contacts we're going to search through. But in some cases, in some triggers, there might be one or more or whatever. So that'll change for each time. And we're just going to loop through this. This starts at this defaults to 500. On your screen, it may be 500. I've chosen 50 just in case something happened and it broke or whatever. I don't know, but 500 just seems like so many. I definitely don't need more than probably 10. But anyway, got 50 here. And then we add a delay step. And the reason we have a delay step is because the loop step happens concurrently. So basically, it happens all at the same time. So it doesn't happen one after another. It happens all together in one go. And so if you're doing a loop that has three parts, there's a chance it can get all three parts at the same time and maybe get confused with the data. So I add in a little delay step. And this is kind of a smart setup of this delay step, basically, which I've stolen from a Zapier genius, Troy, who's put this on, who's mentioned this online. Basically, time, you can do a time delay for a decimal of one. And so rather than having this delay for a whole minute each time it runs through the loop, I'm going to delay it for 0.1. And then I've added this custom detail here, which is coming in from this step, because I've got to stagger these so that one is delayed for 0.1, one's delayed for 0.2, one's delayed for 0.3, so they naturally get ordered. You know, if I delay them all for 0.01, let's say I was to do this manually and I just wrote down 0.1 like this, then they would all still trigger at the same time because they'd all be delayed for the same amount of time. So the way I get around that is I say 0 point and then the loop iteration we can see here. So for each loop, it'll have a different number. If there's two or three or four, it'll have a two or three or four, you know, depending on how many records there are that it's going to loop through. And so that then it will naturally be 0.1 minute, 0.2 minutes, 0.3 minutes for the three different loops. So I hope that makes sense. So that's why I've got that like that into minutes. And then that runs through here. And then we get the contact. So we're pulling in this contact ID from the loop step, because this part's going to run over and over again, however many contacts there are. And then it's going to pull this information from all the contact details from HubSpot. Then we go into step 7, which is the digest step. So this is so that we can kind of collect all the email addresses from these contacts all in one big group. And then we can add it all in one big group at the end to the email. So we're basically kind of appending this email information so that each time the loop runs through, it adds the next email, the next email, the next email onto this. I've called this email. I've got this contact information, get contact email data here. That's going in there. And then I've got the frequency of being manual. So it's going to pair with the release digest step coming up. And so you can actually set this a frequency to like send emails and do other things with this. This is a digest by Zapier step, but I don't need that. I just want to be able to pull the data later in the Zap. And then we go into the last part of the loop. And so this is basically a filter step, which I've called loop stop. And this filter step, what it does is it's looking at the loop iteration. So we're pulling in from this loop step before. We're looking at the loop iteration is last detail. So if it's false, it means that it's still iterating. It's going to do a few more loops. If it's true, it means it's the final loop. And so what we're saying is that when the loop iteration is true, when that's true, then only continue if that's true. But if the loop's still going around and around, then don't continue down this flow. So basically, that's going to then cause it to go back up, do the next loop, back up, do the next loop. And then when that's finished, then it will continue down beyond the loop. If you don't know this loop stop step, when you're adding in these extra steps down here, it's going to loop through all of these and back up again, back up again. It'll keep going down the flow until it gets to the end before it loops up again. So this loop stop is very important so that we continue to go back up at this point rather than following through the next steps in the Zap. So then we jump back to the digest step, or not back to it, we're jumping to the second part of it. We've got the append digest step, and we've got the release data, and this is, I've used this email, the name here, email. That's just basically telling it it's this digest step, and then it's going to pull this information in and put it into a list that we can use in the next step. And then we get to paths. So the reason I've set up a path is that I'm going to have two different kinds of emails. I'm going to have an email that goes out to the multiple contacts when there's more than one email address to go to, and then I'll have one which goes to single contacts. This is because most emails, I would imagine, a lot go just to a single contact. And so we don't want to mess around with all this kind of like all this different formatting to account for many different sort of situations. So we're basically just assuming it's either one contact that it's going to, or it's going to multiple contacts. And so to keep it simple, we've got this one contact path and we've got this multiple contact path. The multiple contact path works like this. So it'll only continue down this path if the line items, the loop total iterations is greater than one. So in that piece before, let's open this up. We've got in the loop step number four, we've got this loop iterations. And then I'm basically saying, is it greater than one? You know, is there multiple iterations, then this is called the multiple, then that becomes the multiple contacts path. If it's less than two, i.e. one or zero, but probably one, then go down this path. And then if it's multiple contacts, then we've got this email here. And in the subject line, we're pulling in the detail we got from the company step, the get company information. So we have my company and then the client's company name here. We've then got the list. Our output of list from step nine, release digest step, that's going in here. So this will be multiple email addresses when this runs in this for this path. We've got our from details, from name. We've got a plain text email that we're sending out. And then we say hello and then company name team. So I'm basically saying this rather than messing around trying to write an email that and you know do all the formatting so that I have all the names in here and it reads nicely and, you know, who knows, maybe there's five different names. Instead, I'm going to assume it's going to more than one. So I'm going to say Star Alliance team. Hello, Star Alliance team. Thank you for signing the contract and submitting your payment. We are excited to work with you all, etc. This is one email. And then the email that goes to one contact, I then have that set up like this. The subject line, same company name. This is then pulling in the same data here. This information here, but it doesn't matter because there'll only be one. If it goes down this path, there's only one. So this will be very simple. And then we have the from details, plain text, email. And now I'm saying the person's first name and I'm pulling this from the get contact step because there's only going to be one. So we have hello, Johan, first name. And then I'm saying the messaging is slightly different because it's just for one person. I'm saying we're excited to work with the company name. Like that. So that's the benefit of having a sort of a singular and a plural version of the email. It means you can change the wording, make it sound more natural like that. And so that's basically it. It looks complicated, but it's not too tricky. If we zoom out a little bit, we can get a bit of an overview. So we go trigger, find the association in HubSpot, the association details. So these are basically the contact IDs, company IDs, etc. So we pull that in from the deals so that then we can do a search in HubSpot to get more detail about those contacts. So we get the company and the company. So we get the company details. We start the loop process. We have a little delay so we can order the different loops. We look for the contact details. We pull the email out and we add it into the digest. We loop. We keep looping. We get to the stopping point. So we loop up. And then we then flow through once the loop's done. We have all the email addresses collected together in this digest from this digest step. So they go in here. We then go to the path, and if it's multiple contacts that the email is going out to, then it goes down this path here into that email. And if it's a single contact, then it goes into this path. The other interesting thing about this setup is that most of these steps, even though it looks like a lot, and in Zapier you pay for each step, all the HubSpot steps you pay for in this, but the Zapier steps, the loop, let's go through. The loop, delay, append, filter, append, path, all of these are free steps, free tasks in Zapier. So the only thing we're paying for, the only tasks we're paying for in Zapier is one here, one here, one here, and the email. Basically four steps, should be around four steps. So it looks complicated, but thanks to Zapier's pricing model, where you're not paying for the Zap steps, you know, in the past they used to count some of them, these days they're all free, then it's not too costly to have this more complicated and long Zap setup. Anyway, let me know what you think about this. Hopefully this is useful for you. I'd love to get your feedback. Before I finish, I'll show you the email, how it looks. So these are the emails that have been added to draft. We've got our multi-person email here, like this. Company name, Star Alliance team, thank you, blah, blah. And then we've got the single person email here. Hello, James. Thank you for signing. We're excited to work with Stargazer Assistantship. There we go. So these two emails, ready to go based on the deal activity. So I hope this has been useful. As I said, add your questions, add your comments. I'd appreciate to hear anything from you. And if you'd like me to go through anything else, please share any ideas or any feedback, any ideas for improving these apps. And if this is useful, please like the video. And if you'd like to see more content like this, it'll be mostly about HubSpot, about Zapier, about sales and digital software and technology, and a little bit of AI as well. Please feel free to subscribe. Okay, I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers.